come to Cypher because they will learn about themselves and they'll learn about their people. They will learn more about themselves. Like, at other schools, you wouldn't learn what we learn here. It's not only based on African culture, it's based on us and how we are as a people, as one, unity.
The strongest area about us is working together. Like, all of the students are able to cooperate with each other and get along. It's not really fights, and we don't have to worry about each other, like, hurting us because we are good at working together.
Ann Sizemore is, like, everything. It's like the teachers, the students, like the way that we do everything, the curriculum. It's like different from many other different schools. Like at other schools, you struggle with peer placement. And like at this school, like it's not that much of a struggle.
Like they teach you about our history and stuff like that. The Harlem Renaissance, it was really cool because I got to learn how they danced and stuff, what it was about, the type of music they played. Like I never heard that music before.
I was walking through the hallway and Mama Jocelyn, she saw me walking and I had an attitude, and she saw me and she told me that I didn't have to be like that. And then she explained balance and how it's like you strive to stay out of conflict with yourself and with other people. You don't have to be everybody else. You can just be yourself.
What excites me the most about being here at Sizemore Academy is when I think about how we provide an African-centered education for students. Some people have a misguided understanding of what it means to have an African-centered education, but the most important thing to remember is that it's really difficult to have a world view or a global understanding if you don't have or know your own personal perspective or point of view. The way we teach children here allows them to understand their self, their people first, and then understand the world around them.
Let me hear you say, be great.
Be great.
Try again, be great.
Be great.
The way that we provide African-centeredness to our students has to do with how we relate to them as human beings. They're not just test scores. They're not just a number to us. These are our children. I take very much a great deal of respect for the fact that children in this village call me Mama Jocelyn. That seems to suggest a much higher standard of relationship than just calling me Miss Mills. And so I think that African peoples are relational first. And I think that when we seek that in children, we're able to help them grow and thrive in ways that other people are not. Emoja!
As a parent here at BASA, I love the fact that he's able to gain knowledge of his culture. I love the fact that every day he walks into the school, he sees teachers, men and women who look like him. I love the fact that he's in classrooms where there are educators who can speak to him holistically. And what I'm going for is they can understand his emotions, why he may feel a certain way, what he needs to excel being a black boy, turning into a black man in society, and it can help him to reach his goals through the light that he's going to have to take those struggles and prepare him before he gets there. And so when my son comes home every day, he's enthusiastic. He's acquired more knowledge of himself, and that's what's most important for me as well as academically.
If you're looking for the best practices in African-centered education, if you're looking for people who've been at it for years, if you're looking for an environment that's going to embrace your child and treat every student like they're our own children, then I would definitely want to look at Barbara Sizemore, because we are right here in the community, in the city of Chicago, and we have a mission of being the best at what we do.
If you need a teacher to talk to your parent or stuff like that, y'all can just bond like that. Their connections with us are so, they're incredible.
They really help you with that kind of stuff. Like, you get somebody to talk to, like, you have, like, a second parent. Or even, like, even if you don't have a parent.
They're richly endowed with who they are. They're valued. They're building student advocacy every day. And that's going to shoot them to the top.
I think that one thing that gets communicated to our teaching staff here, and we are all in agreement on, is the fact that we have all decided that no one should teach Black children better than us, and no one should want to. And so we really take that mission to heart.
If you would like for your student to be close to a teacher, or if you would like for your student to get along with people who look like them, then this is the perfect place.